That was Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, up to the heavyweights, right after that March Madness is over. Like I told you, that doesn't mean the madness is over. Now, let's talk about the loser of the mega fight between Anthony Joshua and Joseph Parker. Your boy Joseph Parker and his team are saying, you know, they're willing probably to fight on the next Anthony Joshua fight, the undercard. They saw how big the undercard fight was with David Price and Alexander Povetkin. And hey, you know, they would do that. They would take ego out of the door and fight on that undercard, you know, because it still would be exposure. And the key would be that it's soon. You know, we know Anthony Joshua was trying to fight in the summer, probably a stadium fight, of course. So Joseph Parker would get right back in the mix. I think this is going to happen. I'm going to tell you why. Because Joseph Parker has moved fast in the first place. This guy doesn't sit out long. Right? I'm pretty sure after this fight, took a lot out of everybody in both teams because it was a big fight. A lot of anxiety and things like that. Take a short break. Joseph Parker will be right back in the mix. I think he should fight somebody that's a little froggy, right? One fight, get right back in it. His elbows are fine now. Fight a froggy dude, and after that, go get the frog. And then after you get the frog, then you're right back in the title mix. I think that we can't put this past Joseph Parker. There's some good things in that fight. I even think if he fought Joshua again, that would be a little bit different, provided some of the things that went on with the referee and things like that. That they would all address the infighting, that infighting is a part of boxing, especially the smaller guy. You know, you couldn't ask Mike Tyson to stay outside all day with his little arms. You had to get inside, footwork to get inside, and then handle your business up in there. Boom, that hook to the body, then bring it up, the uppercut. You know, you can't do that if you're on the outside all day if somebody's 6'6", you know. But those little things, I'm pretty sure that Joseph Parker, being 26 years old, and Joshua, 28 years old, we have a lot of things to look forward to with these guys. And it's just good to see that right away, immediately, Joseph Parker would fight on the next undercard of Anthony Joshua. I think that's good news. I think Joseph Parker should continue to stay in the news. I'm pretty sure he will. He has a following in the UK now, because they know who he is now. So let's see how that is going forward. The opponents are there aplenty in the heavyweight division. So I thought that was good news to hear that Joseph Parker will be probably ready to go this summer. Good lick, mate. Double Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.